What up, what up, what up, fellow agents? Pure Prime here. It's Tuesday again, and that means all the vendors have been resetted. And yes, we can buy that Harmony. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate it. And today, Tuesday again, so that means vendor reset day. So let's see what the White House sells us. A pristine example named Araldi Vest with perfect focus on there, 12% weapon damage, 13.5% repair skills, and 9.4% explosive resistance. And this could be a very nice one. Roll that repair skills away from some crit chance or damage, and you'll have a very nice perfect focus vest, guys. The rest is great, don't get me wrong, but I shouldn't buy it. Maybe that D50 if you're still looking for one to craft your Liberty. This Badger backpack is decent, not my style, just like the Murakami. And then maybe you can buy the 8.3% scan range for your drone if you're still looking for it. But yeah, just leave the rest a little bit too high, and you can find it in the open world as well. So let's get over to the clan vendor, guys. 27 till 30. And for the clan vendor, guys, first piece named DNH, the Punch Drunk. 20% headshot damage always on there, 10.2% skill haste, and 11% weapon damage. In my opinion, leave it here. That skill haste, you don't want that on there, and that weapon damage should be a little bit higher. Negotiator's Dilemma could be nice, but I would love to see that weapon damage a little bit higher, because in my opinion, roll crit chance or damage on here. Hardwired, you know my opinion, just craft it. It's just one thing that you need to get on there, just like in the future with Eclipse Protocol. Season 2 has started today, so in the future we will be getting the blueprints. But if you still need it, you can pick it up. A very decent roll of 9.7% skill damage. But again, I would love to see some status effect on here. X45 Tactical could be nice if you're still looking for the critical hit chance for your library. Rest, it's just a pistol. Then the military M870. Pretty decent, but I'm not loving the shotguns at the moment. You need to be too close, and the ads will take you down pretty quickly. And then over to the MK16, guys. Pretty decent rolls, but I would love to see some else on there as critical hit damage. Strain could be nice, but 11% assault rifle damage bonus, and then 15.5% health damage is nice, but should be a little bit higher. And then the D50, if you still need it to craft your Liberty, pick it up, or yeah, on whatever vendor this week. China Light Vest, 17.7k health on there, 5.1% skill damage, and entrenched. Not that great if you ask me. That skill damage should be higher, and you would love to see something else on there as health. Araldi gloves are very, very nice, guys. 13.5% weapon damage, 5.5% critical hit chance, and 6.7% explosive resistance on there. In my opinion, roll headshot damage or critical hit damage on there, and you have very, very nice gloves. Over to the backpack from Murakami, 9% headshot damage, 4.6% critical hit chance, and protector on there. Not that great if you ask me. Then the mods, 8.7% skill duration, leave it here, open world. One max target, 5.2% skill haste, could be nice, but again, open world. And there it is, guys, this is the must buy in my opinion. 4.5% active regeneration. This is a very, very nice buy. I have a lot of problems finding good mods for my shield. But that's it, guys. Let's head over to the campus. So, campus, guys, let's see. Quite a Roar is the first weapon, and it has very, very nice rolls, guys. 10% critical hit damage already on there. Of course, that perfect overwhelmed. 10% damage to target out of cover, and 6% LMG damage. Of course, you would love to see that critical hit damage different for damage to target out of cover or damage to armor, but this is a very, very nice buy. If you're still looking for it, of course, roll that LMG damage up to that cap and you have a very, very nice gun. SR1, pretty decent rolls, but just leave it here in my opinion. Black Market RPK, very nice rolls. Again, in my opinion, roll that damage to target out of cover a little bit higher, or that critical hit damage away for damage to armor. Then we got the Murakami Mask, 11.2% critical hit damage and 6% headshot damage on there. Then we got the Murakami Holster, 7.4% headshot damage and 17.2% repair skills. Could be nice for a solo build, roll that headshot damage away for whatever you need for your skill build. Then 15.8% repair skills, leave it here, open world. Then 6.4% burn strength, pretty decent one, but again, open world will treat you way better. 4 repair charges is a very nice one if you're still looking for it. And then 5% skill haste, leave it there, open world, pretty easy to find a better one. And then the 4.2 second duration for your shock traps. Pretty decent one, but again, I think open world you can find way higher and you don't have to spend that 4.5k. So let's head over to the theater, guys. Let's see what they sell us. So let's see, guys. The Sokolov Concern Firm Handshake named gloves are the first one. 11% weapon damage. Of course, that 15% status effect on there and 6% weapon handling. Could be a little bit better because you don't want that weapon handling on there, or I wouldn't roll it on there. And 11% weapon damage could be a little bit higher. But if you still need it, in my opinion, get this and roll that weapon handling away. Over to the double barreled shotgun. Pretty decent rolls, but I'm not a fan of the shotgun at this moment. You need to be close and you get downed very, very fast now. Then we got a very, very nice SOCOM M1A. And in my opinion, roll that 5.4% reload speed away for damage to armor, for example, because this already has 14% critical hit damage and a max cap of 15% rifle damage on there. So this could be a very nice buy. Golan gloves, just leave it here, guys. Not that great if you ask me. That armor should be a little bit higher and you don't want that skill damage on there. Grupo knee pads, pretty decent roll, but still almost everything is around 60-70%. So if you really need it, pick it up, but in my opinion, just leave it here. Then we got 8.5% disrupt resistance, very nice. Maybe we can use that in the future with our hazard protection or disrupt build, whatever we need to use in Operation Iron Horse. Over to the 5% skill haste for your mine. Could be decent, but again, open world will treat you way better. Then 1 max target for your drone, leave it here. And 6% duration for your decoy. And I don't know why, but this is one of the things that drops like 10 times for me a day. So yeah, for me, I'm just leaving it here. I don't know why, but they're throwing that 6% duration on me like crazy. But enough about that. Let's head over to the DZs, guys, because the DZs this week have some very nice buys as well. Let's start at the DZ East. So DZ East, guys, let's see. First one is the claws out, and it looks like a god roll because this is almost always a god roll. It will always come with 500% melee damage and 10% pistol damage. So the only thing you have to roll is that status effect or whatever, that third attribute. Classic M44, not worth it for your DZ creds in my opinion, just like the Stoner. The Aces of AIDS mask isn't that great as well, especially not for that 109 DZ creds. Just like the tip of the spear, looking very nice with the attributes, but still 10.3% critical hit damage is very nice. Rolling that weapon damage higher to that max cap, but then I'm not loving the tip of the spear overall. I'm not loving that signature weapon damage and after that weapon damage. But that's just me. over to the Alps Summit mask. Could be a nice one, could be a nice one if you're looking for a solo build to heal yourself, for example, to get that repair skills up. Roll that repair skills on there, or maybe some critical hit damage if you're looking for a skill crit build. Keeler Guard isn't that great if you ask me. Everything should be a little bit higher. That armor regeneration could be nice if you're rocking that Bulwark build, but then you don't want that health, so you want to roll that a little bit higher or something else, and your armor is too low, so just keep it here, especially 101 DZ credits. And then over to the mods, guys. You know my opinion about the mods, just leave him here. Why? Because the DZ credits are too high for these mods. Just go into the open world and you can find them pretty easy, or just go to the normal vendors and buy them with normal money, because we have, of course, a cap of DZ credits. So let's head over to the next DZ, guys. And that's DZ self, guys, so let's see what she buys us. First one is the Maniac. Leave it here, not that great, especially not for 152 DZ credits. Just like the PP90, not worth it. ACR, not worth it. First wave PF45, definitely not worth it. Maybe you can pick up the Eclipse Protocol if you like to. Then, in my opinion, roll that status effect over the headshot damage, because this is a very, very decent status effect build. And of course, you're getting that new talent on there, Symptom Aggravator. Amplifies all damage you deal to status effect enemy targets by 15%. So this could be a very nice boost. If you're still looking for it, you can buy it, but in my opinion, just farm the open world or the missions if it has gear sets. Just like the two Patriots, just leave it here, guys. The rolls aren't that great. 511 backpack are pretty decent rolls, but I'm not loving the combination. Wyvern vest, not that great. Damper proof on there, that's decent. 8.3% critical hit damage, a little bit too low, and at 7.9% explosive resistance, you would love to see some other combinations. And then again, over to the mods, guys. They are pretty decent, but in my opinion, still not worth it to buy for DZ credits. The 6.3% armor repair could be nice, but still, open world will treat you way better. And at 73 DZ credits, is a bit high for me. That 4% duration, that burn duration for your sticky could be nice, but again, I didn't even search for it and I got like 5%. So just leave it here, guys, leave it here. So over to our next DZ, guys, and last DZ, of course. For our last DZ, guys, DZ West, again, the Harmony. So if you don't have it, pick it up. This is the new CMMG Resolute named rifle, and it's very, very overpowered with that perfectly in sync on there. Hitting an enemy grants 20% skill damage for 5 seconds. Using a skill or damaging an enemy with a skill grants 20% weapon damage for 5 seconds. And after that, damage increases are doubled while both buffs are active at the same time. So if you're shooting and your drone, for example, is shooting on an enemy, and it doesn't have to be the same enemy, you will get 40% skill damage and 40% weapon damage only from this talent. And just like you know, I made a build with this gun, and if you're still looking for it, pick it up, because this build is so freaking easy to make and very, very overpowered. You are shredding through everything in the game. It's very fun to play with. Over to the SPAS 12, not that great, leave it here. Then over to the classic M1A, I was very excited to see this, but then I saw the rolls. Just leave it here, guys, these rolls are awful. Foundry Bulwark, if you're still looking for it, pick it up at the DZ West, guys. Roll an explosive resistance away from some armor regeneration and you can participate in the meta. Yay! Negotiator's Dilemma, 10% weapon damage, 17% skill repairs. Not that great if you ask me. I'm not loving that negotiator's dilemma. If you're rocking this, then you need to have some critical hit chance or damage on there, in my opinion. And you would love to see that weapon damage higher. So again, leave it here. This one could be nice if you're still looking for it, but again, 101 DZ creds. The weapon damage is only 11.1%, 7.5% headshot damage, because in my opinion, roll that hazard protection away from some critical hit chance or damage for these gloves. Then almost maxed out Badger Tough knee pads, but why Badger Tough? Shotguns aren't that great anymore, or yeah, you don't want to be that close anymore, not in PvE. And yeah, then you don't want that headshot damage on there, so just leave it here, guys. Looking very nice, but I don't like the combination set. Then over to the 16k armor on kill. Could be decent, but again, open world, guys. Open world for the mods. Maybe this 4.2% active regeneration, but again, we can pick up a 4.3% only for in-game money and not the DZ creds. DZ creds are not stacking up after 300. Over to the 5.9% damage, no, and 5.5% duration. If you want the duration, then just go to another vendor. You will sell you the 6% and just for in-game money, not DZ creds. So yeah, guys, these were the DZs. Let's head over to New York. And then for our first vendor in New York, guys, the Vector SBR9mm. Just leave it here. SMG damage is too low. And if you want a Vector, go for the Tactical Vector. Has the highest base damage. Military M60 could be great. Roll that headshot damage away if you're still looking for it. Then the USC45. Very nice rolls. Damage to target out of cover. And the maxed out rifle damage. And roll that critical hit damage all the way up, and you have a very nice gun, because that rifleman talent is a very nice addition for your rifle. Again, the D50, if you need it for your Liberty or wherever you want to use your D50 for, pick it up at almost every vendor this week. Then we got the Wyvern backpack. This could be nice. The hazard protection and the status effect are both 8.3%, and in my opinion, roll a different talent on there. That energize isn't that great if you ask me. Over to the Murakami knee pads, 6% weapon handling and 14k health. Just leave it here, not great. This could be great, 10.7% skill haste and 17.4% skill repair. This could be a nice addition for your skill build, for example. Pick it up in New York if you're still looking for it. Then the 4.4% critical hit chance, too low if you ask me. 11% protection from elites, not that great in the game. You can use it, but there are way better things to use if you're going for blue mods. For example, that protection from hazard, some fire, some bleed, some disrupt, whatever. That's a better choice in my opinion. Over to the 1% extra sniper ammo, leave it here. One extra max target for your drone, just leave it here. And then 5% blast radius, not that great as well. And then for our last vendor of today and this week, guys, we're gonna visit Roy and see what Roy Benitez has to offer us today. Let's see. First thing is the F2000, not great, leave it here. G28, same, leave it here. Farm the open world, pretty nice marksman rifle, but don't buy it. Just like the Marine Super 90, not great. Reload speed should be something else, so you can roll anything else but steady handed on there. You don't want steady handed on your shotgun. Good luck getting that 100 stacks. M1911 handgun, leave it here. This rainbow vest from Fenris isn't that great as well. Then we got a decent Wyvern knee pads with 8.8% hazard protection already on there. If you're still looking for it, roll that armor regeneration away for whatever your skill build needs. Alps Summit holster could be nice for a crit build, but then again, you don't want that Alps in a crit skill build, but they are decent red rolls. Then we got the 15.8% repair skills, not that great. Open world, go for it. Just like the 4.4% critical hit chance, 1% mortar, 1 max target, and 4.3% duration for your shock trap. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it. I hope this was a little bit quicker and still showing you everything you need to see. And again, very decent vendors, guys. Of course, for us, the hardcore gamers, there's nothing to buy, but I'm loving to see everything around that 60, 50, 70% of the rolls on there. But yeah, that's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.